Hi professionals, this is Utkarsh Rai and today I'm going to talk about boredom at work can be good, bad or ugly. When you first start your job, there is a nervousness energy, new learnings, fresh challenges, excitement to meet new people and a dream of bright future. As the job progresses, it becomes less challenging and monotony. Everyone faces boredom at work. As per Robert Half blog, employees feel bored 10.5 hours per work week. But boredom could be ugly, bad or good depending upon how do you deal with it. Ugly when boredom becomes chronic. Boredom is as damaging and stressful as burnout. Even on those days when you are not working, you will not feel fresh. Boredom saps energy. It ruins your self-confidence, self-worth and morale. Longer you stay in this zone, you start to become irritable and argumentative at work, dashing any hope of promotion or new challenges. It takes an ugly toll on your health too. Bad when boredom becomes longer. It's a symptom that you are outgrowing your job. There is a lack of excitement because your skills and experiences have surpassed the work at hand. Disenchanted, you started looking for a job change. As per Korn Ferry 2018 report, 33% of people who are looking for a job change cited one reason. I am bored, need new challenge. After a few years into your new job, you started to feel bored again and again started looking for a job, but this time it might be difficult to find. It is bad for your career too. Many a times in my career, I felt bored too. I talked to my manager and sometimes I got new challenging assignment and sometimes not. Over a decade back, an interesting episode happened. I was bored. I talked to my manager. He smiled and said, I have given you everything what I can. Why don't you enjoy your life? Initially, I felt upset and later I realized his intent. Philosophy professor Andreas Alpidoro said, in the absence of boredom, one would remain trapped in unfulfilling situations. We will miss out on many emotionally, cognitively and socially rewarding experiences. Boredom is both warning that we are not doing what we want to be doing and a push to motivate us to switch our projects and goals. So watch my video until the end where I am going to talk about how you will convert boredom into a good use. And if you have not already liked and subscribed to my channel, then please do it. Good or beauty of boredom. Professionals loosely define boredom as lack of interest or difficulty in concentrating. But artists defined it differently. For them, boredom is a lack of engagement. And the more they are disengaged, they will cease to be an artist. So let's have a look into artist's boring life and learn four important traits. First, follow daily ritual and schedule. Artists follow daily ritual and strict schedule, irrespective of whether they are in a good or a bad mood. They follow the same work pattern every day. Only a few days they generate good art, but most of the days it is not good, but it does not perturb them. Pulitzer Prize winner Maya Angelou wakes up at 5:30 a.m. and she starts writing from 7:30 a.m. for 5 or more hours, irrespective of good or bad days. You might find disciplined life boring, but actually it helps you in achieving much more in that time. Second, new insights through repetitive actions. People want to make fast bucks. Patience to hone and sharpen skills has reduced. People argue, why to hone skills beyond a certain point when most of the domain skills are getting obsolete soon? They are right, but they miss a bigger picture. When you hone a skill, it takes time. During that process, you form a habit. Once a habit is formed, you are going to learn any new skill faster. James Clear, author of Atomic Habits, said, improving 1% daily isn't particularly notable. Sometimes it is not even noticeable, but it is going to be very meaningful, especially in the long run. Discipline is the key factor for habit formation. Boredom should challenge you to go deeper to find new insights. Peter Thiel, co-founder of PayPal, was working on an approach to fight fraud. He got new insights when 9/11 happened and he formed Palantir, where he started providing data mining services to security agencies. Repetitive actions might appear boring, but actually this is what is going to give you new insights. Third, persistent steps towards improved performance. After following daily ritualistic schedule and habit of repetitive actions, artists take the path of perfection through progress. For artists, boredom is actually to take repetitive actions and continuous engagement. If you see any initial work of an artist, you will wonder whether this is the person who has done this. Thomas Edison's electric bulb had undergone 10,000 iterations before it came for a real use. 10,000 iterations must be boring. But they learn, they take corrective actions, relearn, and take further actions. Many professionals hop from one job to another job to overcome boredom. But then come a time in their career when they start feeling stagnant because they have not gained enough experience by staying in one company to go deeper, to get new insights, and then to take actions. Michelangelo said, "If people would come to know how hard I work to get mastery, it would not seem to be so wonderful at all." Mastery comes beyond boredom. And fourth, context switch to get refreshed. Artists also go through mood swings. They do context switch in that situation. They leave their work and do something very different, get refreshed, and come back to their work. So you can also pick up any art, hobby, or sports to do context switch. And this is what my manager meant when he said, "Why don't I enjoy life?" Because he wanted me to get refreshed and re-energized and bring new energy to the world. So professionals, you have seen how by following artist boring life, you can learn these four important traits to make your work more meaningful. I hope you like this video. Do like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.